intelligence officials warned that ISIS leaders had trained cells of operatives for coordinated international attacks.
9 attackers armed with automatic weapons and grenades opened fire.
The despicable attack bears the hallmark of ISIL's depravity.
In this kind of security environment, we need to be dynamic and responsive. With a global coalition of over 60 nations, we're taking the fight to ISIL across the physical, virtual, and ideological battle space.
We've authorized a series of steps to ratchet up our fight against ISIL. Additional U.S. personnel, including special forces in Syria, additional advisors to work more closely with Iraqi security forces, additional assets, including attack helicopters, and additional support for local forces in northern Iraq. Our aircraft continued to launch from the USS Harry Truman. Our B-52 bombers are hitting ISIL with precision strikes.
Our international coalition has a steadfast commitment to this mission. We will continue the attack, we will maintain the momentum we have, and we will defeat them in Iraq and Syria on our watch. One mission, all the way.
We always said it's going to take a long time, but working as a coalition to rebuild an Iraqi security force that had been totally demoralized and almost on its back, to getting them back up, to getting them trained, and then to retake a city like Ramadi, one of the most difficult terrains and urban environments to fight in, I think we've made quite a bit of progress.
Across our government, at every level, federal, state, and local, military and civilian, this campaign at this stage is firing on all cylinders. Our message is clear. If you target America and our allies, you will not be safe. You will never be safe.